Hi everyone, welcome back to Bank Exams Today, and this is our day 13th of 5 minutes vocabulary, which isn't exactly just 5 minutes vocabulary. We take at least 7 to 8 minutes to learn 5 new words. Basically, the purpose is to learn 5 new words and to use them in sentences. I hope you all are liking the video lesson series, because we are working really hard to provide you the words that are actually useful for your SBI PO exam, SBI clerk exam, IBPS PO and IBPS clerk exam. Basically, these words are also going to help you when it comes to reading comprehension, so that you can understand the context of the passages very clearly. Okay, so we first start with the word irate. Irate means someone who is very irritated or someone who gets angry very quickly. Irate. You can memorize this word with the word irritated. Irritated, someone who is actually baffled, confused and has extreme emotions of anger. So irate is a similar kind of word to express a feeling which is resulted from anger. Like, this person is irate. But irate is an adjective, so it will be used to qualify a noun. Okay, he is angry, furious, infuriated, incensed, enraged and incandescent. All these are the synonyms of irate, while the antonyms are cheerful, because when a person is angry, the opposite should be happy and cheerful, pleased or calm. Example, the irate women. Irate women, it means the women who is very angry. Women vandalized her boyfriend's car when she learned he was cheating on her. Vandalized means he just smashed the car. Okay, so the next word today we have is incessant. Incessant means continuing without pause or interruption. Like, some of our teachers in college were keep on speaking and the lecture was actually very boring. I'm not disrespecting them, but sometimes a person has to face a situation that is unpleasant and it is continuing for a long period of time. Like, this person is speaking blah 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 without any interruption. Okay, so incessant means continuing without any pause or interruption. Keep on speaking, keep on doing whatever the person is doing, and actually this kind of situation is unpleasant. Incessant lecture can be there, incessant talk or incessant anything, a situation which is very much dull and boring and it is continuing. Okay, so synonyms are ceaseless, that does not stop, unceasing, that does not cease, constant, unabating, interminable, eternal. It feels like it is going to be eternal. There is no end to this thing. Interrupted is antonym, because something which is incessant, which means it is going on without any pause, interruption. But antonym should be interrupted. Infrequent, because it is not continuing frequently. It is terminating, and transient, which is temporary. Example is, with no cure in sight. It means there is no cure, no remedy. Melinda will continue her incessant battle with cancer. Incessant means continuing battle, the battle which will never end. Third word for today is immaculate. Immaculate is an adjective. Okay, it will qualify a noun, and immaculate represents something which is perfectly clean. There is no spot or any stain. Like this room, it is extremely clean, spotless and unstained. Can you spot any stain on the floor, on the walls, on the doors of the wardrobe, closets? No. So it is immaculate. Immaculate is an adjective used for the things or places that are perfectly clean. So the synonyms should be clean, spotless, pristine, unspoiled, unstained and unsullied, something which is very pure and clean. Antonyms are defective, because when something is clean, the opposite should be defected. It has some kind of defect, it has some kind of stain. Imperfect, this is perfect, but opposite will be imperfect. Tainted and flawed. Synonyms are, since I'm having guests over for dinner, my house must be clean until it is immaculate. It means the house should be extremely or perfectly clean. Fourth word today is ignominious. Ignominious means an act that deserves public disgrace or shame. For example, a girl elopes with a boyfriend, that is an ignominious act. Something that is disgraced publicly, that is humiliating for the other people or other people related to that person. So ignominious, deserving or causing public disgrace or shame. Sometimes when a child fails in the exam, that is also a kind of disgrace for the parents. It shouldn't be, because not every child is bright in learning. So they consider it ignominious because they think the child should top the school. So they think that if their child is failing in the exam, it is a kind of humiliating or shameful situation for them. So ignominious, something that causes or that deserves public disgrace. Like when a corrupt politician is caught red-handed, he deserves to be disgraced publicly. Okay, so ignominious, deserving, shame or disgrace. Synonyms are humiliating, undignified, embarrassing, shameful and disgraceful. It is an adjective, so it will be used with a noun. Antonyms are respectful, dignified, graceful and honorable. So example is, because he divorced his wife and later married her sister, Henry has an ignominious reputation among townspeople. Ignominious reputation which is undignified, or he has a disgraceful reputation in the among people. Now the word is preponderate. Preponderate means to be extremely large in number, that it outweighs the other. For example, you go to a family wedding and you see there are a lot of girls and only few boys. So it means girls are in great number, that they are overpowering boys. They are dominating the number of people or number of male present is there. So preponderate means to overpower something, to dominate others or to prevail everywhere. Like this person is preponderating others. So synonyms are dominate, he is dominating others, predominate, prevail. It means he emerged to be the strongest one. He is the most influenced person or the most important person. And it also means command or control. Antonyms, follow. Because if he is preponderating, it means he is leading. But opposite should be following, obeying, surrender and yield. Christians preponderate in the population of that part of the country. It means the Christian people dominate the other people in that part of the country. Like in India, Hindus preponderate other people or the people belonging to other religions. It means they outnumber them. So this is all about today's five words. And if you like these words, you know what to do. Like this video, share it with your friends and family members, and you can comment the sentences that you make using all these five words that you learned today. And if you face any doubt, you can drop an email at raman@bankexamstoday.com. Okay, and the PDF is available to download in the description box. So thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.